Greetings, my esteemed subscribers. Today I thought to talk a bit about my book Dauntless. I mentioned it briefly in the Wild Hunt challenge video I made a while back, but as I said in that video, I was going to make a separate video on the book later on, so this is that video. Now, it was actually 4 years, almost 4 years ago, since I also made a video on this channel saying that I will write a book. So it took a good few years to complete, and most of it is written over the last 2 years. I would say the chapters written back in late 2015 and early 2016, most of it I had to rewrite because, well, I have matured a bit over these years, and the language is a bit better, I hope, now at least. So that is the story there. And why did I want to write a book? Well, basically it is so I could have all of my teachings, so to speak, in one place. So I can have read this book and you will get a good view of my views on training, nutrition, philosophy, politics, worldview, everything like that. So if you want to know that, you can order the book from any of the links in the description box. And for anyone who's already read it and come back with the positive feedback to me, thank you so much. It is very heartfelt indeed, and I feel extremely motivated to keep writing. And I have actually started upon my next book, not only because I feel so motivated by your kind words, but also because I had, of course, planned to write more books. This is something I wanted to do for a long time. I've always wanted to write books, and I have a lot of things to say, and to be able to do it via the written language in books is a privilege in my view. But anyway, I just wanted to say thank you to everyone who has bought it and who has read it and come with good words of it. So that is the status on the book itself. Now, I also thought to give an update upon Jotunheim nutrition, because I know a lot of my lads in good old America and Canada are asking when is Jotunheim nutrition available in Vinland, and it's actually worth for me to elaborate upon this in a video. I of course talked a bit about it on my Instagram too, but the reason is that in Sweden, when it comes to dairy products, production of whey, everything that is related to foods are heavily regulated. So if we look upon treatment of cows that produce dairy, is very, very high in Sweden. I would say the highest in the world. Sweden is extreme in some cases in a bad way, but we're also extreme in some cases in a good way. So I know that the whey protein that I sell, that are being done by Swedish cows on Swedish farms to Swedish customers, or customers in Sweden at least, I know those cows are being treated fairly, because I've said this before, I'll say it again, I've grown up in the countryside, I've seen how these cows live. They go out in their pastures and they have, from what I've seen, a good and decent life. Now, I'm not particularly comfortable with setting up some sort of manufacturing or buying the whey in American factories, because I don't know how they are being treated. I know full well the standard of the product that I can sell here in Sweden. I know the quality. I can't do the same thing in America, and I can't ship food halfway across the world, because it is not sustainable and it's not congruent with my personal philosophy. So two things stand in the way of Jotunheim nutrition opening up in America. So what I would have to do, and hopefully, I don't know, but if everything goes according to plan, maybe I can find a good, solid farmer who can supply ethically sourced whey in America that I can then sell on to customers there. Because I've seen the darker sides of both the dairy industry in America and also of the supplement industry, because you don't have the same levels of testing in America as you have in Sweden. So for my products, for example, here I have plenty of certificates. American companies usually do not have the same. So some advice for you all in America, if you are buying whey protein, for example, do trace the source of them. Do check out where they are coming from. Check out what sort of facility the dairy that the whey is being made out of, where does it come from? Are the cows being treated fairly? And this also, even if you don't care about the cows, the resulting product will be better if the cow feels better. So that is the situation there. But again, I would absolutely love to open up Jotunheim Nutrition to Canada and the US, but it's a long way there, and I want to make sure that when I sell a product that it's legit. I don't want to sell on a whey from mistreated cows full of dodgy chemicals and all sorts of metals in. I want to keep it clean. I want to have it at the same standard as I have here in Sweden. So anyway, thank you for watching and have a great weekend ahead. XOXO, boom.